Hi friends, I'm Arpita Karwa, and in this video I'm going to talk about research tools. Now I've already made a lot of videos on paper 1 in which I've tried to summarize each and every unit. I've given you a crash course in those video lectures, but there were a lot of students who are commenting on our videos saying that we want you to take each and every topic in detail. So this is a new series in which I'm going to talk about different topics of paper 1 individually. But before I move on and talk about research tools, I would like you to go to my YouTube channel and look at the playlist which is called UGC NET Preparation. In that playlist, I have posted a lot of videos talking about how you can revise, what all the study tools you can use in order to boost your preparation, study timetable, mistakes you should not do on the day of exam, how you should revise during the last week. So all these videos are going to help you for the next NET exam, because I know that all of you must be anxious, worried about how to approach this UGC NET exam because it's happening online for the first time. So go check that playlist and get benefited from the videos I've made. So now let's understand what is a research tool. Now we all know that tools are things which aid you or assist you in a task. For example, there's a woodcutter. Now he is going to use a tool which is called axe. Now with the use of axe, he's able to cut trees. So his work is to cut trees, and what is helping him to cut trees? It's axe. So axe is a tool for the woodcutter. Similarly, if you look at a researcher is doing a research, and there are a lot of tools which are going to help him to collect data, to collect information. Because research involves gathering information, analyzing that information, and then coming to a conclusion. So in order to collect information, he might use a lot of tools, and these are known as research tools. Now, aisa nahi hota hai ki ek researcher bolta hai, chalo main ye use karta hu because this seems nice. No, there are different criterias based on which he is going to choose the perfect research tool. For example, there's a researcher who wants to research on 20 people. Now, if he wants to gather information from these 20 people, he might use a research tool which is called interview. Whereas, if he wants to conduct a research on 20,000 people, then it is going to take him a lifetime if he interviews those 20,000 people. So, in that case, he will use questionnaire. He is going to distribute that questionnaire to the people are going to fill their information, and then he's going to collect the data. So selecting the perfect research tool is going to depend upon a lot of things. It is going to depend upon the nature of the research, number of participants involved, and a lot many other criterias. In this video, I'm going to talk about some important research tools which can be used by a researcher in order to carry out his research. So let's go. So let's first look at the number one research tool, which is interview. Now we all know how an interview is conducted. There are a lot of interviews we must have read or we must have watched on television. If you look at the magazines, you find that all of these magazines are going to have certain interviews in each of their edition. Similarly, if you look at television, then there are a lot of shows which are running which are based on interviews. For example, Coffee with Karan, a very popular show. It is about Karan Johar interviewing other Bollywood celebs. Similarly, if you look at Arnab's show, in that Arnab Goswami is interviewing different political leaders. So interview is an oral conversation in which the interviewer is going to ask a few questions, and the person who is being interviewed, he is going to give us information based on the question. So it is a research tool by which you can gather information about a person. Now there can be two kinds of interviews. One is structured interview and the other one is unstructured interview. What is structured interview? Structured interview is when you prepare the questions in advance. So that means your questions are predetermined. Suppose one day I get to interview Virat Kohli, and if I have structured interview, then in that case I have listed 20 questions which I'm going to ask him, and then he's going to respond back. Okay, whereas on the other hand, if I'm going by the unstructured interview, then my next question is going to depend upon the interviewer's response. For example, if Virat Kohli says that I love watching movies in my free time, I might ask him a question that please tell us some of the best movies which you've seen repeatedly or some of your favorite movies. Now what am I doing? I've not written any questions. Whatever he's saying, on the basis of that, I'm making up new questions. So these are two common kinds of interviews which can be used by the researcher. So when you look at interview as a research tool, you might find that it's very good when it comes to collecting detailed information about a person. But on the other hand, if you look at interview from the point of view of time, then it is extremely time consuming and expensive at the same time. Why? Because if I want to conduct a research on 20,000 participants, it is going to take me 10 or more years to interview each and every person. So it's very time consuming, it's expensive. But if my research is on a particular group, and if I'm only targeting a few people in my research, then in that case, interview is going to be your best friend. The second kind of research tool is questionnaire. Now, I'm pretty sure you must have filled one or the other questionnaire in your life. If you go to restaurants towards the end of your dinner or lunch, you're given a feedback form in which they are going to ask you a set of questions about the experience you had in the restaurant, the kind of service, food, ambience. Now, this particular question set which you are given is known as a questionnaire. What is questionnaire? Questionnaire is a series of written questions which are given to participants in order to collect information. Now, there's this annoying ad which I see on Hotstar these days. Whenever I watch a movie on Hotstar, it comes a time when there's an ad which says, now everything is online. So if you want to improve your online experience, participate in this survey and answer some questions. And they're going to give you a list of questions which you need to fill. Now, this is a perfect example of questionnaire. Questionnaire can have two kinds of question. One is open-ended question and one is closed-ended question. What is a closed-ended question? A closed-ended question is where you either have a yes or no response. Multiple choice answer jo hote, that is a closed-ended question. For example, if I ask you, do you like tea? Now you can either answer yes or no. On the other hand, if I ask you an open-ended question, describe the biggest achievement of your life. Now in this case, you're going to give me a detailed answer based on a thoughtful response. That is called an open-ended question. So in a questionnaire, you can either have closed-ended or open-ended question, or you can have a combination of closed and open-ended question. Now the best thing about a questionnaire is that it is used in surveys. Survey mein questionnaire aapko bahut jaldi bahut sare participants ka data la sakta hai. Unlike an interview, because interview is extremely time consuming and it is not suitable when the research is going to happen on a bigger lot. On the other hand, if you want that you should research on more than 10,000, 20,000 people, then the best possible way to gather information is by using questionnaire as a research tool. The only demerit about questionnaire is that you are not physically present, so that personalized touch is missing. Somewhere the response which the participant has given, you cannot validate that. If I'm using an interview, in that case, I can question the person again. I can look at the body movements. I can look at the gestures and postures and figure out a lot more things. In a questionnaire, there's no physical contact between the researcher and the participant. Therefore, a bit of ambiguity is there. But still, it can give you a lot of material related to your research, and therefore, it is the most suitable form of research tool. The next kind of test is standardized test. Now, what is a standardized test? A standardized test is when the data is collected from different participants and that data is going to be interpreted and scored in the same way. That means जितने भी participants हैं उन्होंने जो जो बताया है उसे एक standard तरीके से measure और score किया जाएगा. This is the reason why it is also known as assessment. Standardized test का other name is assessment test. You need to understand the fact that the best thing about standardized test is that the score of one participant is compared to the group and then we see how well that participant performed. A very common type of standardized test is achievement test, which happens in schools. Schools mein test liya jata hai, weekly test, monthly test, semester wise. Now what happens when these tests are taken? Every student is going to be scored in the same way. There's a standard answer. On the basis of that standard answer, your answer is judged. And then a score is calculated. This score is then compared to the students, other students' score, and then a rank is being given to you. So for example, if I have got 10th rank in my class, that means there are 10 people ahead of me and 50 people below me. So if the class strength is 61, then if I'm having rank 10, that means there are 9 people who are ahead of me and then there are 50 people who are below me. This is known as standardized test. And one common type of standardized test, do remember, is achievement test. Last but not the least, we have rating scale as a research tool. Now, what is a rating scale? I'll give you a very simple example and I'm pretty sure that you'll relate to that example very well. You must have purchased any product from an online e-commerce site like Amazon, Flipkart. After you purchase the product and the product is delivered at your home, they ask you to rate your experience. Okay, and they'll shoot an email in which you'll be given a rating scale in which 0 means bad and 10 means excellent. And you're asked to mark any one number telling them about your online experience. And suppose you mark number 8, that means you had very good but not excellent experience. Okay, so that is rating scale. When you collect information by using the rating scale. So this is another type of research tool which a researcher can use to gather information. So with that note, I end this video lecture. I've tried to talk about various different types of research tools which you can use or you can study if you are preparing for UGC NET Paper 1. I've already made a detailed video on Paper 1 research methodology. You can check that on my channel. So now that you've seen different types of research tools which you can use as a researcher to collect information, it's time to look at UGC NET previous year papers and find out if we have ever got any questions from this particular section. So before you leave, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, click on the bell icon, also like and comment if you have any other doubts, any questions which you want me to address in my videos. That's it for this video lecture. We'll meet very soon in the next video. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.